just weeks away from a historic summit between U.S. President Joe Biden and Vladimir Putin, and Russia is already firing a shot across the bow.
The number of problems are growing. There comes a time when they can be no longer dealt with. And the United States, with its confident gait and firm step, is going straight along the path of the Soviet Union.
Look, the Treasury Department's laughing, aren't they? The reality is that Russia has been making the same noises since 2014.
It seems as if over the last week or so, the rhetoric, at least on the Russian side, has been amped up. I mean, de-dollarization?
I compared U.S.-Russia relationship to a falling knife. And we need to catch this knife on the 16th till it falls, to the floor.
U.S. sanctions have forced the government to essentially create a buffer to geopolitical headwinds. Their gold stockpiles are up. They've joined forces with OPEC producers. And they built a 5G ecosystem ripe for a digital boom. Should those in the United States who are having these conversations be concerned about that move to digital currencies, that it could undermine the status of the U.S. dollar as the world's reserve currency?
We're not concerned about undermining dollars, you know.
Considering all these geopolitical threats, we think that we should have different structure of our reserves than other countries.
Does that then, in effect, essentially mean that U.S. economic sanctions now are less effective than they were?
We learned how to live with sanctions, for example, Russian banking sector. You know, this year for us is extremely successful in spite of the sanctions.
Is there a possibility that we could see oil contracts denominated in something other than U.S. dollars?
If our American partners create this type of situation, we shall have no other choice but to gradually do that.
You have allegations of Russian hacking, when you have human rights, what's the strategy to get around that? I mean, are you having a direct conversation with Vladimir Putin saying, this is bad for business? Got it out.
I think we all need to just, agree to disagree on some issues, but really understand that stability of relations and dialogue is at the core of stability.